I'm not going to tell you to wake up early in the morning so that you can gobble down all the different fins of the fish and their respective functions. Neither am I going to tell you to cut down your entertainment time and further stretch your study time so that you can memorize different components in the cross-section of the dicotyledonous stem. Because to be frank, both of us know they are not realistic and this is not the reason you are here for. So in this video, I'm going to tell you the method to score an A plus in biology, which is the 4-2-1 rule. The video will be divided into different parts. Watch until the end to master all the simple yet very effective method to score an A plus in SPM biology. So without further ado, let's get started. 4-2-1 rule is a very straightforward approach. Basically, it means after your first read of your reference book, in your second read, you will memorize 4 headings, 2 subheadings, and have 1 time recall. And you will write down what you have recalled in your notebook. For an instance, an animal cells, after first reading of all the organelles, the second read, I will just memorize 4 organelles. Let's say I remember Golgi apparatus, mitochondria, smooth endoplasmic reticulum, and rough endoplasmic reticulum. Then we settle with the first rule of 4-2-1 rule. So we now proceed to the 2 subheadings. Subheadings means different things in different situations. It can be functions, characteristics, benefits, or explanation. In the organelles, it means the functions. So I remember 2 functions of Golgi apparatus, 2 functions of the mitochondria, likewise for smooth and rough endoplasmic reticulum. After I've done with my chapter, I will put the book aside and I will have the one-time recall of what I have memorized just now, and I'm going to write it into my notebook. This is how it looks like. I prefer to use different colors for headings and subheadings so that they will have a sharp layout and later it will be easier for me to study. So, how 4-2-1 rules works in the exams? Let's look at the past year paper. So the first question is, diagram 1 shows an animal cells and the question asks which structure A, B, C or D is a smooth endoplasmic reticulum. In this situation, I hit my big 4 because they're asking the question that I have memorized. The answer is B and there's no confusion over here because I memorized them so clearly that I know it is just the right answer. I won't be pondered over should I choose A or B because they kind of look similar. And what if the luck doesn't hit us this time? So we'll look at the next question. This is the trial paper questions. The following statements refer to organelle Y. Small cylindrical structure forms spindle fibers during cell divisions. So here, the first thing I will do is to cross out the mitochondria because I memorized it. I know it is not for the cell division. And then second one, nucleus. Everyone who study biology, even you don't memorize it hard, we know that nucleus is for genetic material, so here I will cross it out as well. Then we are left with lysosomes and also centrioles, which we didn't memorize. But it is okay, because in my first reading, I know that lysosome is to break down something. And now the statements clearly didn't point to breaking down of some products. So I'll confidently choose D and this is the answer. That's how 4-2-1 helps in ruling in or ruling out the incorrect answer so that you can choose the answer confidently. Other than being a game changer in kertas 1, it also works wonderfully in kertas 2. Let's see how it works. So in kertas 2, 70% of the questions ask for an explanation. But in here, you remember 2 explanation, right? Take the example of the type of the transportation. If the question asks for active transport, you already know it by your heart. It is against the concentration gradient and you require energy to do that. So you got 2 marks in hand. And I do notice that some questions allocate 3 marks for the explanation questions. Leftover 1 mark, you can get it from the heading. Maybe heading is the thing that they look for. If not, you also can search from your memory. Remember, you got first reading of your reference book and it is going to help. For the essay as well, it works because the maximum marks allocated for each question stem in the essay part is just 10 marks. So remember, you got 4 headings, 2 subheadings for each heading. So 4 plus 8 equal to 12. You actually have out of 10 marks to score. If you are a genius and you are so confident that you can memorize all the facts from the reference book, like Success, which is this thick, there's no need to watch this video. But let's think of it realistically. You have 10 subjects and each reference book is this thick. So you might want to ask yourself, is it possible to remember all the information from the reference book? The answer is with you. If you are struggling with paying a lot of efforts but yet you are not satisfied with your score, or your score is close to the passing line, this may be the reason why. You try to remember 10 organelles of an animal cells, but on the test day, you remember 2 to 3 of them, and you barely remember their functions. This is as if you pay 100% of efforts, but yet you get the answer wrong, you get 0% in return. But if you apply the 4-to-1 rules, you are paying 40% of efforts, you only remember the big 4. And when you come to the questions, you can confidently rule out the incorrect answer and also get the correct answer. So it is same like you paying 40% of efforts and you get the answer correct because there's no confusions, you are just crystal clear of the correct answer. You get 100% in return. But as usual for learning, there's no hard and fast rule. So you can always customize 4-to-1 rules according to your needs or according to the situations. For example, the animal cells, because I know it is just going to come out in the exam, so I would just follow the 4-to-1 rules. But for the question, which rarely come out in the trial paper, the past year paper, and for the questions that you really wonder, do I have to memorize this? You can always downgrade your 4-to-1 rules into 3-to-1 rules or 2-to-1 rules. But I would kind of go against upgrade to 5-to-1 rules because it takes too much effort and it didn't pay as in return. The topic wouldn't be asked that intensely in the exam. For example, you won't expect 10 questions on the organelles because they have to make the proportion to be balanced, to be fair. So now I'm going to tell you a bit about passive and also active learning. Active learning has really done a great job in improving my score, so I really like to share with you here. So in the 4-to-1 rule, I also integrate the active learning, which is the active recall. In 4-to, the first 2 steps of the 4-to-1 rule use passive learning. So passive learning is basically reading and rereading again to memorize the facts. But then, study shows that the integration of active learning into passive learning can actually help to improve the learning experience and maximize the outcome. I hope you guys didn't skip this step because even though you don't recall as successfully as you think, still it helps in memorizing of the facts. On the side note, the notebook that you use to write down your recalls can be helpful a week or even a day before the exam. When you don't have that plenty of amount of time to flip through your reference book to look for what you have memorized for your headings and subheadings. And now we'll talk about how to make full use of practice questions. This method has also helped me in improving my score tremendously. So if you are doing practice questions, don't skip this step. When you are juggling over whether you should choose A or B, you would scribble beside A, why do you think the answer is A? And what makes it not to be the answer, and also the same for B. When you are checking back your papers, you are marking it, you will look for the information to clarify anything that's not clear. If you don't write it down properly, you won't remember why you are confused over the answer choices, and you are risking of making the same mistake in your next practice questions or in the SPM. On the day before the exam, take out your golden 1 million notebook. I mean, if there are people who want to buy it from you at 1 million ringgit, don't sell it. At least wait until you finish your bio paper. So, you take out the book and revise it. Consolidate your memory. The most important thing is go to bed at a time when you should be. Study also shows that sleeping helps in memorization. That's all for 4-to-1 rule and the learning methods to score an A+ in biology. I hope you enjoyed this video and feel free to comment below. Remember to subscribe to my channel if you're looking for more study tips and study motivation. See you in my next video. Bye!